The haunting case of the Somerton Man.
70 years ago, a man's body was found on a beach in Adelaide.
He'd slumped against a seawall and dressed in a suit and tie.
When the autopsy was carried out on the body, it soon became obvious that the man didn't die of natural causes.
An unlit cigarette resting on his chest, double-breasted jacket, perfectly pressed, a book of Persian poems and a coded note.
And that little note in his pocket that said, to mum should, it means it is finished.
Was he a Russian spy?
Even the labels on his clothes had been removed.
A ballet dancer.
He had particularly big calf muscles, which a ballet dancer may have.
A lover scorned.
She told the police that she didn't know who he was.
Now one man claims he's cracked the case.
We've identified the Somerton Man. His name is Charles Webb.
Professor Derek Abbott has spent more than a decade trying to identify the elusive Somerton Man.
In 2011, the police let us have access to hairs of the Somerton Man. We were able to now compare his DNA with millions of people on family tree type databases. We found a distant cousin, and so we built out the family tree of that cousin. Charles Webb was in that tree. He was from a family with six siblings. They all have dates of death and death certificates, except for Charles.
Charles Webb, less a spy, more a 43-year-old electrical engineer and instrument maker from Melbourne. The mysterious pair of scissors and a knife ground to sharp points, the clothing in a suitcase labelled with the name T. Keane.
Charles Webb has a sister called Frieda, and she was married to Thomas Keane. Being an instrument maker also means he has access to a metal workshop.
And the Persian poem and letters that appeared to form a code?
Turns out that he wrote poetry, and this so-called code are strange letters. This is just the first letters of names of horses. Turns out Charles Webb was a keen racing fan.
This afternoon, South Australian police stating they are heartened by the recent development and cautiously optimistic this may provide a breakthrough.
It still leaves a lot of questions though. He was certainly on that beach for a reason, and until we find out why he was there and how he died, the mystery will continue.
It was slightly premature to say the code's been cracked, the case has been solved.
Yes, no, it hasn't been solved. But I've just found that every revelation was like the most ordinary, disappointing version it could have been.
I know.
It was, what, horses, race horses? That's not exciting.
I know. Where's the Da Vinci Code in that?
Yes.
But how incredible, though, all the decades of work, though, to solve that.
Yeah. And it's a convincing case. Like, you're looking at it going, I mean, all I know is this two-minute TV package, but I'm convinced.
And also, I tell you now, if I see anybody with big calf muscles, ballet dancer. I know.
All I reckon is that you just need to make sure that the circumstances of your death are clear, otherwise people are going to rifle through your stuff and read your poetry, which no one needs.
I promise you we won't.
Okay.